Hey, Ubers. I'm having issues. Not personally. I'm having issues with these. And here's my issue. So the past couple days, I went out crappie fishing. And hopes to get a few, you know, for fish fry and all that. Well, there's a fisherman out there normally with about four of these set up. He's not fishing them. Like, this one buoy, not this, this is my personal buoy. But he'll have a buoy set up for 30, 40, 50 minutes. I timed it, and he's nowhere in sight. Now, I understand having a couple buoys out and, you know, fishing at one, 15 minutes, letting the other one have a break, and then going back to it a little later, but an hour to 40 minutes, that's not fair to us other fishermen. I started zigzagging, making my way through and around, trying to find more brush piles. Now, I didn't find any. Now, unfortunately, on a kayak, we can't cover as much ground as you can in a boat. But I couldn't find any. So I was very frustrated. But I still had fun, of course. I was fishing. I caught a few crappie. But it made out to be a crappy day because I didn't catch what I wanted to catch. I have a solution. And my solution is to create my own fish habitats without anyone else knowing until they randomly just approach it and run it over their fish finder. So that's the project today. I'm going to create a fish habitat, plant it somewhere secret after hours so no one's really paying attention, and then hopefully in a few weeks the crappie and the bass will start getting on it. First, I need some materials.
Aha, irrigation. This should do the trick. Let's see here. Oh yeah. Right here. We have it's $10.35. It's 100 foot of half inch tubing. That's what I'm looking for right there. $10, super cheap. I need one of these. Check. On the same aisle, how convenient. I need buckets. Okay, this is kind of harder with one hand. Right there. So the Homer bucket is $3.25 with the lid is $1.76. Like we'll just get one bag of this. Should be plenty. $5.48.
Alright, we got the materials. So here's what you need if you want to do the same project. You need a roll of this 100 foot poly tubing. It's irrigation tubing. Second, you need a bag of concrete. This is the Quikrete. It dries in 20 minutes, it's very fast setting, so. And lastly, you need a bucket of some sort. Woo-hoo. And a lid. All right. So I have the receipt to this whole project, $22.74. So this one crappie habitat, or bass. So now it's time to assemble. Here's the tools you'll need for this project. 5/8 drill bit, because we have half inch tubing, so fit in there perfectly.
A power drill.
Some type of snips. I'm using a wire metal snip, so it should cut through easily on this tubing. And that's it. That's it. All right, let's get rolling. So first off, you just randomly put some holes in this bucket. Now I'm gonna try to keep all the holes. See the bottom of the dew? I'm gonna try to keep all the holes above that, so that way I can have quite a bit of concrete in there where it's just gonna stage up and not ooze and drip out of the side. So my goal is to keep it above the dew and have all this space to work with.
Let's do it.
So I'm gonna put one hole on one side and then spin it and try to do it exactly the opposite side. About. Of course, it don't have to be perfect, just close. So I got quite a bit of holes throughout. I might have made it a little too uniform, but hey, it'll be okay. I don't think the fish are gonna judge it too much. I mean, it's in an orange bucket. I mean, okay. So I got pretty uniform holes all around. Like I said, I did one on this side and one exactly opposite side, so on and so forth. Keep it semi-uniform. So now it's time to do the tubing. Measure out one, cut it, and save it as a guide for your next several or however many you're gonna cut for that length. Another thing I discovered If you don't have anything to crimp the ends with, just take some scissors, go inside one end that you're going to shove in the tube, just cut a centimeter or less of the tubing. I'm just cutting it in three spots, like so. Just trimming it down a little bit. When you start shoving it in the hole, it will mold a little better and fold over each other. So pretty crazy looking, but it's coming together. It's kind of looking like a bottom of a Christmas tree, so perfect. So this is what we got so far. On the top of it, I do have a hole every 4 inches. Then below the top of the rim, I have it kind of up and down, like steps. You step up, step down, step up, step down, all the way around it. Like I said, I stopped at the bottom of the do and left that space for concrete. There'd be a little overflow over the top of that, but mainly I want enough concrete to fill this bottom part here. So it's coming together nicely. I'm gonna put this out of the way. This part is done. All right, next we got the lid. I'm gonna drill some holes in the lid and apply some more of that, that tubing in through the top. I am gonna peel off this little barcode. I know I'm putting trash in the lake, but this is paper trash. It'll fray off easier, so I know it's not a huge deal. Either way, I'm littering, I guess. But anyways, so I got a clean lid. Let's drill some holes in this. All right, so I got 5 random holes. We'll see after we punk some tubing in there, see how that looks. So here's what it looks like with the lid on. I just have the lid lightly laid on there. I still got to do the most important part. I just put concrete on the bottom. And but I just wanted to give you a quick showing. Now it's time to mix the concrete. So since the YouTube police are out, wear appropriate safety gear, a mask, goggles for sure, says so on the bag even, and some gloves. And over here to my left, I got 2 pitchers of water. Probably don't need that much, of course, but went ahead and have it on standby. Do use cold water. Hot water makes it go quicker, and you don't want it to go too quick where you can't even mix it anymore. Mixing bucket. This is separate from my project over there. Just gonna mix it in here and dump it in. I got a little yard shovel to help stir it and mix in all the dry pockets. So I got about 1/3 of the bucket full. It's probably a little too much. Now I'm gonna add some water. I'm gonna pour a little bit and work that in. So that's about the consistency I want it. Kind of some rocky mud that I'm looking for. It's pretty thick and chunky.
I like them thick and chunky.
I'm gonna go ahead and dump this in. So here's the D of my do that I told you about earlier. You can tell the mud line is slightly below that D. So I lifted on it and it's actually pretty good weight. So it'll sink pretty fast. Here's how much water I end up using. I just, used 1 pitcher and just 2 quarts of that pitcher, just half of a pitcher. That's all the water I needed to make that thick mud consistency. All right, I put my lid on and there she is. I got the Holiday Inn Express fish habitat going on. It looks pretty awesome. I like it. I like how it turned out. Pretty inexpensive and super easy to do, and it was a fun craft. I did think though, on the next bucket I make, this handle right here, I mean, that's gonna be a pain in the butt for snags. I may or may not do it with this project, but I had an idea. I have some leftover PVC pipe from my last project, And I'm going to go get an end cap from Home Depot, drill a hole big enough for this PVC pipe, and put that end cap on the other side of the lid, and just have it long enough where I can lower it down into the water instead of using this handle, and drop it the rest of the way. I'm in shallow water. It's about 15 feet deep, so it's not going to veer off too crazy. This is more snag proof than this stupid wire handle. So it serves its purpose for anything and everything but a fish habitat. So that concludes this project. I have to say, it was a lot of fun. I really enjoyed it. That's my first time ever creating one of those habitats. And again, I'm not fishing from a boat, so I couldn't make it super extravagant. It's not a very tall habitat per se, but I think it's perfect for what I'm wanting to accomplish with it. And it's manageable on my kayak. Like, I can put it back in the Milk Creek area and paddle my way or pedal my way to the drop-off point and drop it in the water. It's not super heavy where I feel like I'm going, hopefully, I'm not going to tip over into the water with it. I am planning on making another habitat. If you look over here, I still have at least 50 feet of tubing left and half a bag of concrete. And I have another Homer bucket right over there. I just need to go to Home Depot and buy a lid. So basically you can do two habitats for $25. You just need to spend the extra $3-4 on another bucket or lid, unless you already have one at the house. So still got plenty of product left to do a whole nother fish habitat, which that's the plan anyways. This one was a trial, see how much tubing I would end up using in concrete. And plus, I want to go paddle it out there. I'm only going to take one bucket at a time. I think two probably a little too much on my kayak, but one be manageable. I'm going to drop it off one spot, and then the next week or whenever I go back to that area, drop off the other one pretty close to it. And of course, you know, the bigger the habitat, the bigger fish population could be on that habitat.
Oh yeah!
Thanks for watching. Until the next adventure.
Deuces!